How to Build a Global Cooperative. One Community Weekly Progress Update, number 458.
One Community is a 501c3 nonprofit organization. We are creating open source and free shared blueprints and resources, tools and tutorials, and do-it-yourself instructions for highest good living. Creating solution models that create additional solution creating models in the service of all life on this planet.
My name is Jay Sable, and I'm the executive director of the One Community 501c3 nonprofit organization. One Community is bringing together people with the consciousness and the desire for the highest good of all life on this planet to build sustainable, self-replicating, and regenerative teacher demonstration hubs as a pathway to global sustainability. And this is our January 2nd, 2021 edition of our weekly progress update. Happy New Year! And today's topic, which is a great topic for a new year, is how to build a global cooperative, which if you're somebody that follows the news, we could probably use a little bit more cooperation in today's political and economic climate. Like, we could maybe work together a little bit better. And so the question is how do you build a global cooperative? And for an organization like ours, it's all about sustainability. How do you build a sustainability global cooperative? And we have a very, very simple and logical answer to that question. You make it easy enough, you make it affordable enough, and you demonstrate it's attractive enough so that it can spread on its own. This is the recipe for making something viral. And so we want to make sustainability viral. We want to make sustainability easy enough, affordable enough, and attractive enough to spread on its own. And to achieve that goal, everything that you see happening in the background of this video, everything you see, hopefully I'm pointing the right way when I do that, I have to check. Everything you see happening in this video is designed with that intent, to make it easy enough, affordable enough, and attractive enough to spread its own. And we are open sourcing and free sharing all of it so that we can provide something for everyone. They might think like, how are you going to provide something for everybody? You know, I mean, so people are so diverse, that's impossible. Now it's like, well, the way that we're approaching it is we've looked at sustainability as much, much bigger than just physical sustainability. And we've divided sustainability into two major categories. We have physical sustainability, which everybody knows about. It's food, it's energy, and it's housing. Like food, energy, and housing, those are the foundations of sustainability that most people are familiar with. But there's also the emotional foundations of sustainability. And so when we think about how to build a global cooperative, we're like, well, what about the emotional components that are arguably, debatably, even more important than the physical components? And so those emotional components that we're addressing, we call highest good approaches to fulfilled living, highest good approaches to education, highest good approaches to economics, and true earth stewardship. And so we're putting all that together to demonstrate a way of living that most people will consider to be better than the way they're living right now. And we're addressing the food, the energy, the housing, the fulfilled living, the education, the economics, true stewardship, so that we can provide something for everyone. Even if people aren't interested in complete ecosystem design or, you know, teacher demonstration hubs is the complete model that we're creating, is to take all the individual components and we're open sourcing each of those individual components so that they can be replicated either on their own or as the complete teacher demonstration hub model. But for people that aren't interested in the complete teacher demonstration hub model, we have all the individual components. Maybe somebody just wants to run a homeschooling program, or maybe somebody's interested in our ecotourism design and wants to run an ecotourism destination that doesn't have anything to do with necessarily like an eco village, you know, or maybe somebody is interested just in our energy infrastructure. You know, and so, you know, the energy, like we're just recently completed a tutorial on how to connect a solar farm to the grid. Well, somebody could use that as an individual if they wanted to understand, like, how much is it going to cost me per mile to run, you know, an above ground or below ground power line to my property? And what is the infrastructure that I need if I'm just an individual who wants to, you know, live off grid with an on-grid backup? You know, rather than having a completely off-grid system to be able to sell money back to the grid. And we finished a tutorial on how the energy exchange rates as well, and energy credits, like metering. So these are the kinds of things, like we're providing something for everybody. Maybe people aren't interested in that stuff at all. Maybe they don't care about that. There's interest in, say, a home schooling education program, or maybe a great way to recycle glass or clothing. Like, that would be in our stewardship tutorials. Or paper. You know, we get people emailing us fairly frequently now about, oh, we want to talk to you about paper recycling. Like, we've created a whole tutorial about that, and it's drawing attention. So this is how we look at building a global cooperative, is by creating an open source suite of resources and tutorials and educational information, tools, tutorials, resources, do-it-yourself instructions for all aspects of highest good living, putting it up on the website as open source and free shared content, and continuing to develop it indefinitely. And one community, as the complete model, will be a place where initially 20 people, then 50, then 100, then growing to 400, then growing to 2,000 people will work together to create more and more open source tools, tutorials, and resources, and in collaboration with others around the world, using our plans to create that global cooperative of teacher demonstration hubs, working together towards a common goal of creating even more teacher demonstration hubs and evolving everything that it is that we're doing, creating more iterations and different versions of it, adaptations, modifications, and evolutions of the foundations to stimulate the entire sustainability industry by creating a set of plans, permitted plans, with cost analysis, with purchase orders, with tutorials on how to deal with your local governments and planning commissions, things like that, to be able to get these items, permitted plans, so you can get these things pushed through to make it easier and easier to build sustainable infrastructure like we're designing, and teaching people how to do that, to demystify the process, to simplify the process, and, of course, to make it easy enough, affordable enough, and attractive enough to spread on its own, and creating that foundation so that people that have the money that would have normally spent tons and tons of money just covering the basics, like right now we're doing compression testing, you know, to compression test for aircrete and for earth bag, you know, mixes, stabilized earth mixes, so people don't have to pay for those things. They don't have to pay for the basic plans. Instead, they can put their resources in creating even more beautiful things. You know, so you're still going to hire an architect if you want to change what it is that we're doing, but now you have the resources to have that architect build amazing things instead of spending a bunch of money to build the basics. And so this is why we talk about like evolutions and new iterations of what it is that we're creating, and how we will work hand in hand with those that want to take our plans and open source and free share their evolutions and improvements to the same level that we are. We want to work with those. And so that's the tight-knit global cooperative that we're creating. And then there's more like the fringe global cooperative of just putting out the information for free, sharing it for free, giving it away, and the cooperation and collaboration that will just happen from people just interacting with our information, interacting with each other, and taking these designs that are designed to the best of our ability to be highest good approaches to the food, the energy, the housing, the fulfilled living, the education, the economics, the truer stewardship, highest good approaches to all those, and just putting that out in the world for free. And people just using that, because even if people use it without ever contacting us or ever talking to us, it's still a step in the right direction if they chose that over toxic materials, you know, toxic paints, toxic adhesives, you know, growing food organically without herbicides, pesticides, or fungicides, you know, thinking about renewable energy and implementing those things in their lives, improving biodiversity, these kinds of things, all of those are a step in the right direction. So all this work that we're doing, we're open sourcing and free sharing it because we want to help this information replicate throughout the world. So we're an all-volunteer organization doing this, including myself, 100% unpaid, nonprofit organization, non-governmental organization, creating this because we want to live this way, creating this because we want other people to have access that would want to live this way, to be able to do that easily and affordably. And creating it so that we can demonstrate it as one community, the physical location that people can come and live in and experience. And the more fun that we're having, and the more we're sharing what it is that we're doing, the more successful this creation will be. And that is our gift to ourselves, it's our gift to the world, and what it is that we're dedicating our lives to. So if this is interesting to you, subscribe. Subscribe to our channel. Visit us. Check us out every week. Get your weekly dose of good news and like, let's create an amazing world because we're capable of doing this, and see what it is that we're doing. If you'd like to see specifics of what our all-volunteer team has done, check out our written blog with the same name. It's linked in the YouTube description below. And stick around for a couple more minutes if you'd like to see bullet points of all the major components for our project. This is our website. If you'd like to see details and specifics, visit our helping page. If you'd like to get involved in some way. And until next week, we will, of course, keep on keeping on open sourcing and free sharing how to build a global cooperative one component at a time, seven major components simultaneously: food, energy, housing, fulfilled living, education, economics, and truer stewardship, putting all those together, open source and free shared for the world. Thanks for following our progress. Till next week, we'll keep on keeping on. Thanks.
The one community approach to highest good housing is eco-artistic home building that is affordable, sustainable, do-it-yourself duplicable, resource and space efficient, and consists of seven different sustainably constructed village models. One Community is also creating an open source duplicable city center. It is designed to be LEED Platinum certified, provide 12 guest rooms, dining for over 150 people, and laundry and recreation space for over 300 people, all while saving money, time, space, and resources. One Community's approach to highest good food is duplicable almost anywhere, scalable for different needs, more biodiverse and nutritious, part of forwarding a global open source botanical garden collaborative, and includes 9 different free, shared, and duplicable growing environments.
The next component is highest good education. This component is complete and pretty much ready to launch once we're on the property.
One Community's approach to highest good education is designed for all age groups, adaptable to any schooling environment, inspiring and fun for all participants, includes national standards, all subjects, lesson plans, teaching strategies, learning strategies and tools, classroom design, and more. The One Community approach to highest good society is globally focused, individually enriching, cooperative and collaborative, includes a highest good network and application, 4 different economic models, and combines fulfilled living and true earth stewardship for the benefit of all people and all life on this planet.